Good morning to you all. Let us start the second chapter in part first, that is solutions. In first year, you have studied about the pure substances and mixtures. Pure substance and mixtures. So pure substances are those which have a definite composition. For example, water, glucose. These are the examples for pure substances. In water, hydrogen and oxygen are combined in a fixed ratio by mass. And in glucose also, carbon, hydrogen and oxygen, all the elements are combined together in a fixed ratio by mass. So these are the example for pure substances and they have fixed composition. Whereas in case of mixtures, it has variable composition. For example, mixture of salt and water or mixture of sugar and water, all these are examples for mixtures. And pure substances, we cannot separate the components of pure substance by simple physical methods. Like hydrogen and oxygen in water, we cannot separate it by simple physical methods. Whereas the components of mixtures can be separated by simple physical methods. Mixture of salt and water, sugar and water, we can separate by simple physical methods. In mixtures, again there are two types of mixtures: homogeneous mixture and heterogeneous mixture. There are two types of mixtures: homogeneous mixtures and heterogeneous mixtures. In homogeneous mixtures, the components are completely mixed with each other and the concentration is uniform throughout the mixture. Whereas in heterogeneous mixture, the components do not mix with each other completely and the concentration is not uniform throughout. Example for homogeneous mixture: salt and water or sugar and water. Heterogeneous mixture: mixture of sand and water or oil and water. These are the example for heterogeneous mixtures. So solutions are the mixtures in which the two components completely mixed with each other and the concentration is uniform throughout the mixture. And heterogeneous mixture, the components do not mix with completely each other and the concentration is not uniform throughout the mixture. And our topic, that is solution, is a homogeneous mixture. Solution is a homogeneous mixture where the two components completely mix with each other. You might remember the topic surface chemistry. In that we studied about colloids, that colloids are heterogeneous mixture. Colloids are heterogeneous mixture and solutions are homogeneous mixture. So as in case of colloids, we have two components, dispersed phase and dispersion medium. Here in the case of solution, we have solute and solvent. As in the case of colloids, we have dispersed phase and dispersion medium. In the case of solution, we have solute and solvent. The main difference between the solution and colloid is their particle size. In colloids, the particle size is in between 1 nanometer to 1000 nanometer, whereas in solution, the particle size is less than 1 nanometer. If the particle size is less than 1 nanometer, then it becomes homogeneous mixture and we call it as solution. If the particle size is slightly larger than that of the solution, then we can call it as heterogeneous mixture. And in that, we call the two components as dispersed phase and dispersion medium. Okay? So solution is a homogeneous mixture. Solution is a homogeneous mixture of two or more components. If you have two components, it is called binary mixture. In this chapter, we are going to study about the binary mixtures. And coming back to pure substance and mixtures, in our daily life, we rarely come across pure substances. Most of the substance we are using are mixtures. And the importance of this mixture depends on its composition. For example, brass and bronze. Brass is a mixture of copper and zinc, and bronze is a mixture of copper and tin. In both the substances, the only one difference is in brass the components are copper and zinc, and in bronze the components are copper and tin. But the properties of these two substances are entirely different. And one more example we can take as a concentration of fluoride. The low concentration of fluoride prevents the tooth decay, whereas if the concentration exceeds 1.5 ppm, it may cause the tooth to become colored. And at a still higher concentration, it can be used as a poison. For example, sodium fluoride, it is used as a rat poison. So the importance of a mixture depends on its composition. In solution, we have solute and solvent. Let us study about what is solute and what is solvent. In a mixture, the component which is present in smaller quantity is called solute. The component which is present in a smaller quantity is called solute, and the component which is present in larger quantity is called solvent. In a solution, we have two or more components. In this chapter, we are going to study only about the binary mixture, means solution containing only two components. In that mixture, the component which is present in smaller quantity is called solute, and the one which is present in a larger quantity is called solvent. If you prepare the mixture of salt and water, we take water in a larger quantity. In that case, water becomes solvent, and we add salt in a smaller quantity, and salt is solute. Remember the solute and solvent. While solving problem, we take solvent as the first component and solute as the second component, or we use the suffix 1 for solvent and 2 for solute. Please remember there, solvent is used as a component 1 and solute is taken as a component 2. In a homogeneous mixture, the component which is present in larger quantity is called solvent, and the one which is present in a smaller quantity is called solute. So this is about introduction to solutions. So we have pure substances and mixtures. Pure substances have definite composition, whereas the mixtures have variable composition. The components of pure substances cannot be separated by simple physical methods, whereas the components of mixtures can be separated by simple physical methods. There are two types of mixtures, homogeneous mixtures and heterogeneous mixtures. Homogeneous mixtures, where the two components completely mix with each other. In heterogeneous mixture, the two components do not completely mix with each other. And solution comes under homogeneous mixture. So the components of the solution are called solute and solvent. And one example for heterogeneous mixture is colloids. Colloids comes under heterogeneous mixture, as colloids, the components of the colloids are dispersed phase and dispersion medium. We have solute and solvent in solution, right? Next, study about the types of solution. We have different types of solution. So at this stage, I want to make one point clear that don't confine the word solution to only liquids. There are solid solutions and gaseous solutions also. So let us study about the types of solution. So based on the physical state of solute and solvent, we have 9 types of solutions. So here, if it is a gaseous solution, so in this table we have type of solution, solute, solvent and examples. In the gaseous solution, the solvent is always gas, and in liquid solution, the solvent is always liquid, and in the solid solution, the solvent is always solid. The solute may be gas, liquid or solid in each case. Okay? So first let us take the type of gaseous solution. In the gaseous solution, if a solute is gas and solvent is also gas. The example is a mixture of oxygen and nitrogen gas. Mixture of oxygen and nitrogen gas. So in a mixture of oxygen and nitrogen gas, oxygen present in a smaller quantity and nitrogen is present in a larger quantity. In that case, oxygen becomes solute and nitrogen becomes solvent. Okay? In a gaseous solution, if a gas is a solute and another gas is a solvent, means the solute gas is present in smaller quantity and solvent gas is present in a larger quantity. Example is mixture of oxygen and nitrogen. Here oxygen is a solute and nitrogen is solvent. And another type of gaseous solution is a solute is a liquid and solvent is gas. Example is chloroform mixed with the nitrogen gas. Here chloroform is liquid which is present in a smaller quantity and nitrogen is a liquid gas which is present in the larger quantity. So chloroform is solute and nitrogen is solvent. And the third type of gaseous solution is a gaseous solid solute and gaseous solvent. The example is camphor in nitrogen gas. So camphor is solid which is present in a smaller quantity, hence it becomes solute, and nitrogen is present in a larger quantity, hence it is a solvent, right? So these are the three types of gaseous solutions. And the next type of solution is liquid solutions. So in liquid solution, we have gas as a solute and solvent is liquid. Example is oxygen dissolved in water or soda water. These are the examples for liquid solution. Here oxygen dissolved in water. Oxygen is present in smaller quantity, hence it is solute. And water is present in a larger quantity, hence it is a solvent. And second type of liquid solution is liquid in liquid. One liquid is dissolved in another liquid which are completely mixed with each other. Example is ethanol dissolved in water. Ethanol is a liquid and it is present in a smaller quantity, hence it is a solute, and water is present in a larger quantity, hence it is a solvent. And the third type of liquid solution is solid dissolved in liquid. We can get a familiar example for this. Glucose dissolved in water, salt dissolved in water. The salt or glucose, whatever we take, is in a smaller quantity, hence it is a solute. And water is present in a larger quantity, hence it is a solvent. And the third type of solutions are solid solutions. Here, solvent is solid. Solvent is solid and solute may be gas, liquid and solid. In case of gas in solid, the example is solution of hydrogen in palladium. We use this as a catalyst for hydrogenation reaction. Hydrogen in palladium. Hydrogen is present in a smaller quantity which is a solute, and palladium, a catalyst which is present as a present in a larger quantity, and hence it is a solvent. And second type is liquid in solid. The example of amalgam of mercury with the sodium. Amalgam means paste. Paste of mercury with the sodium. Mercury is a liquid which is present in a smaller quantity and sodium is a solid which is present in a larger quantity. So mercury is solute and sodium is solvent. And the third type of solid solution is solid in solid. Copper dissolved in gold. The small amount of copper is dissolved in gold, and that copper is called solute and gold is called solvent. So this is one of the important type of solution, solid dissolved in solid. We may get question like, give an example for solid dissolved in solid type of solution. Example is copper dissolved in gold. So these are the 9 types of solutions. In colloids we have 8 types of colloids. So in colloids we replace this solute as dispersed phase and solvent as dispersion medium. As colloids are heterogeneous mixture, the mixture of gas and gas is not considered as a colloid because it becomes a homogeneous mixture. So these are the 9 different types of solutions. So just look at this table and remember the examples, familiar examples like oxygen dissolved in water, ethanol dissolved in water, glucose dissolved in water. These are the very simple examples, oxygen dissolved in water or carbon dioxide dissolved in water as in the case of soda water, and ethanol dissolved in water and glucose dissolved in water. So in this chapter we are going to study about the gas dissolved in liquid and liquid dissolved in liquid and solid dissolved in liquid. So for that you must remember these examples, familiar examples. Gas dissolved in liquid, that is oxygen is dissolved in water, liquid dissolved in liquid, ethanol dissolved in water, solid dissolved in liquid, that is glucose or salt or sugar dissolved in water. Next, let us study about the concentration of solution. So we may define the concentration of solution qualitatively or quantitatively. Qualitatively, we may say that the solution may be dilute or concentrated. If a solution is dilute, means it has a less amount of solute in it. If a solution is concentrated, it may have large amount of solute in it. So these are the qualitative expressions of concentration of solution. It may be dilute solution or concentrated solution. But quantitatively, we can express the concentration of a solution in different ways. Okay, the first concentration term is mass percentage. It can be also expressed as W by W, mass percentage. So mass percentage of a solute in a solution can be defined as mass of the component in the solution, mass of the component in the solution or mass of solute in the solution divided by total mass of the solution into 100. Okay, so mass percentage of a solute in solution is mass of the component or mass of the solute in the solution divided by total mass of the solution into 100. For example, if you have 10% solution of glucose by mass, it is given that we have 10% solution of glucose by mass. It means that 10 grams of glucose, 10 grams of glucose is dissolved in 90 grams of water, so that the total mass of the solution becomes 100 gram. 10% glucose solution by mass means 10 gram of glucose is dissolved in 90 gram of water, so that the total mass of the solution becomes 100 grams. So if you substitute here, mass of the component or mass of the glucose is 10 or 10 grams. Mass of the glucose is 10 grams. Total mass of the solution. Total mass of the solution means 10 gram of glucose plus 90 gram of water. So 10 plus 90, that is 100 into 100. So we get answer as 10%. We get answer as 10%. So 10% glucose solution means 10 gram of glucose is dissolved in 90 gram of water. And the total volume, mass of the solution should be 100 grams. So this term, mass percentage, is used in the industrial chemical application. So based on the application, we can use different concentration terms. So this mass percentage term is used in the industrial chemical application. One more example is the commercial bleaching powder, which is 3.62%. Commercial bleaching powder is a 3.62% of sodium hypochlorite solution in water. 3.62% sodium hypochlorite solution in water means 3.62 gram of sodium hypochlorite is dissolved in the remaining amount of water, so that the total mass of the solution is 100 grams. So this is one of the example for mass percentage. So this is a first concentration term, mass percentage. So mass percentage of a solute in solution can be defined as mass of the component in the solution divided by total mass of the solution into 100. Suppose we have 20% of glucose by mass means 20 grams of glucose is dissolved in 80 grams of water, and total mass of the solution is 100 grams. Suppose we have 25% by mass of glucose solution means 25 grams of glucose is dissolved in 75 grams of water, right? So this is how we can write the mass of solute and solvent if the concentration is expressed in mass percentage. You should write the mass of solute and solvent if the concentration is expressed in mass percentage, like this. 10% glucose solution by mass means 10 gram of glucose is dissolved in 100 grams of water, right? And let us solve one problem based on this mass percentage. We have one problem here. Just write the formula. Mass percentage is equal to mass of the component in the solution divided by total mass of the solution into 100. So here the problem is, calculate the mass percentage of benzene CC6H6 and carbon tetrachloride CCl4 if 22 gram of benzene is dissolved in 122 gram of carbon tetrachloride. So we have two components, benzene and carbon tetrachloride. In a mixture, we have two components, benzene and carbon tetrachloride. So benzene, the mass of the benzene is 22 gram. C6H6 is 22 gram. And mass of carbon tetrachloride, CCl4, is 122 gram. In a mixture, we have two components, benzene, C6H6 22 grams and carbon tetrachloride 122 grams. Here the one which is present in a smaller quantity, that is benzene, is a solute, and the one present is a larger quantity is solvent. So the question is, calculate the mass percentage of benzene and carbon tetrachloride. So substitute here by using the formula, mass of the component in the solution divided by total mass of the solution into 100. The solution is, mass percentage of benzene can be calculated as mass of benzene divided by total mass of the solution. So in solution we have benzene and carbon tetrachloride. So mass of benzene plus mass of carbon tetrachloride into 100. The mass of benzene is 22 grams and total mass of the solution is 22 grams of benzene and 122 grams of carbon tetrachloride into 100. So that gives a mass percentage of benzene. Similarly, we can calculate the mass percentage of carbon tetrachloride. Mass of carbon tetrachloride divided by mass of benzene plus mass of CCl4. So that is 122 grams divided by 22 grams plus 122 grams into 100. So these are the mass percentage of benzene and carbon tetrachloride. So mass percentage of benzene 5.1%, sorry 15.2%, it comes out to be 15.2%. And mass percentage of carbon tetrachloride is 72%. Sorry, that is 84.72. So that the total percentage is 100. So second concentration term is volume percentage. Volume percentage of a component in solution can be defined as volume of the component divided by total volume of the solution. Into 100. This is the formula to find out the volume percentage of a component in the solution. Volume of the component divided by total volume of the solution into 100. So if we have 10% solution of ethanol by volume, if we have 10% solution of ethanol by volume, this means that 10 ml of ethanol is dissolved in such a amount of water so that the total volume of the solution is 100 ml. 10 ml of ethanol is dissolved in some amount of water so that the volume of the total mixture becomes 100 ml. So in the case of mass percentage, we taken as 10 plus 90 is equal to 100, or 10 gram plus 90 gram is equal to 100 grams. But if you mix the two solutions or two liquids, the 10 ml plus 90 ml need not be 100 ml. It may equal to 100 ml or greater than 100 ml or less than 100 ml. So if I say 10 ml of ethanol is dissolved in 90 ml of water to become 100 ml solution, it is wrong. So 10 ml of liquid plus 90 ml of water, it need not be equal to 100 ml. It may greater than 100 ml or less than 100 ml, and we will discuss it later in case of ideal solution and non-ideal solution. This concept will again come. And here 10% solution of ethanol by volume means 10 ml of ethanol is dissolved in some amount of water so that the total volume of the solution is 100 ml. So if you substitute in this formula, volume of the component is 10 ml, total volume of the solution is 100 ml into 100. So the answer becomes 10% by volume. So this is about volume percentage, and this is one of the example for volume percentage is 35% of ethylene glycol in water. The solution of 35% of ethylene glycol in water, ethylene glycol, that is CH2OH and CH2OH, ethylene glycol. 35% of ethylene glycol in water means 35 ml of ethylene glycol is dissolved in some amount of water so that the total volume of the solution is 100 ml. And the importance of this solution is it is anti-freezing agent, means it reduces the freezing point of water to minus 17.6 degree Celsius. Usually water freezes at 0 degree Celsius, but if you use anti-freezing agent, it may decrease the freezing point of water to minus 17.6 degree Celsius. It has many applications, this anti-freezing agent. So this is one of the example for solution in which the concentration is expressed in volume percentage. So volume percentage of a component means volume of the component divided by total volume of the solution into 100. Just note this difference. In case of mass, if you mix 10 gram plus 90 gram, it may equal to 100 gram. But in the case of volume, 10 ml plus 90 ml need not be equal to 100 ml. In very rare case, it may equal to 100 ml. In some case, it may greater than 100 ml or less than 100 ml. So one of the example is 10% ethanol solution by volume. This means that 10 ml of ethanol is dissolved in some amount of water so that the total volume of solution becomes 100 ml. So next, the third concentration term is mass by volume percentage. So mass by volume percentage, it is simple, the amount of solute present in 100 ml of solution. So mass means amount of solute present in 100 ml of solution in volume, mass by volume. So this concentration term is used in medicine or medicinal bottles. You might have observed in case of medicinal bottle, the composition percentage is expressed in mass by volume, the mass of the component present in 100 ml of the solution. What is amount of solute present in 100 ml of the solution? That is mass by volume percentage. And the next concentration term is parts per million. Parts per million or ppm. Important term, parts per million or ppm. So if concentration of the solute is very small, in that case we use the term ppm. For example, the concentration of the pollutant in water or atmosphere are expressed in ppm, parts per million. In case of percentage, we write it with respect to 100, right? In the case of parts per million, we write it with respect to million or 10 to the power 6. The formula is number of parts of the component divided by total number of parts of components of the solution into 10 to the power 6. This is a formula, very simple one. It is parts per million, number of parts of the component divided by total number of parts of components of the solution into 10 to the power 6. So here we can write the number of parts. Parts means it may be applicable to mass or volume or mass by volume, anything you can write. Mass of the component divided by total mass of the solution into 10 to the power 6. Or mass volume of the component divided by total volume of the solution into 10 to the power 6. In that way also we can write mass by mass, volume by volume, anything. But here we should write, instead of percentage, we should write 10 to the power 6. So one example is, if water weighing 1030 gram, it contains 6 into 10 to the power minus 3 grams of dissolved oxygen. So the mass of the solution is 1030 grams and it contains 6 into 10 to the power minus 3 grams of dissolved oxygen. What is the percentage of this oxygen in water? Okay. So if you calculate this by using ppm, mass of the component, that is 6 into 10 to the power minus 3 grams. Mass of the component is 6 into minus 3 grams and mass of the solution 1030 grams, 1030 grams into 10 to the power 6. See, compared to the total volume of the solution 1030 gram, the dissolved component, mass of dissolved component is very small, 6 into 10 to the power minus 3 grams. So in that case we can use the term parts per million. Mass of the component divided by total mass of the solution into 10 to the power 6. The answer is comes out to be 5.8 ppm. Answer is 5.8 ppm. So we can write the answer in ppm. So this is how we can express the concentration in ppm, parts per million. This is a formula, but we can apply this for mass or for volume or for mass by volume. Anything we can substitute here. And next concentration term is mole fraction. It is expressed as X. Suppose in a solution we have two components A and B. We have the components A and B. If you want to know the concentration of A in the solution, we can use the term mole fraction. Or if you want to know the concentration of B in the solution, we can use it as mole fraction. Or we may have one more component C. A, B, C. If a solution has two or more components, and if you want to know the concentration of one particular component, we can use the term mole fraction. So mole fraction of X can be written as XA. It can be calculated as NA divided by NA plus NB plus NC. Means N means number of moles. Number of moles of A divided by total number of moles in the present in the solution. NA, number of moles of A, number of moles of B, and number of moles of C. Similarly, XB can be calculated as NB divided by NA plus NB plus NC. It is number of moles of A, number of moles of B, and number of moles of C. Or the mole fraction of third component, XC. XC is equal to NC divided by NA plus NB plus NC. This is how we can calculate the mole fraction. I hope you remember to how to calculate the number of moles. Number of moles, N is equal to mass by molar mass. Mass by molar mass. So this is the term mole fraction. In a mixture of different components, if you want to know the concentration of one particular component, we can use the term mole fraction. So in a mixture, if it has three components A, B and C, if you want to know the concentration of only one component A, then we can write it as mole fraction of A, XA, is equal to NA divided by NA plus NB plus NC, where N means number of moles, and number of moles can be calculated as mass by molar mass. Thank you.